水老弟尔康也给这位当红女星造成了永远无法修复的创伤，逼她喝下含有毒品的酒，强行脱掉她的衣服，并试图强上刚满19岁的她。他俩的恶行直接摧毁了这个女星的音乐生涯。如果你没有做好心理准备，请不要看这期视频，因为它会颠覆你的认知。点赞关注。开车，19岁的 Nicki Hilton 凭借与传奇说唱组合 Migos 合作的 Bad Intention 大获成功之后，她在2014年成为了美国当红的女歌手，并极有潜力成为下一个 Super Star。而就在这个时候，音乐巨星康也盯上了她，而巧的是，康也正是她音乐上的偶像和灵感来源。
And I was 19 years old, like I had just left home, and all of a sudden I got a call one day, and it's like, hey, like Kanye wants you to come to the studio, and we were just like what? Like Kanye knows who I am? Like what? This is crazy.So we go.
Nicki 一想能和康也在录音室做音乐，他激动坏了。但是当他和经纪人劳伦一直走进录音室，看到眼前的场景，他马上就慌了。
And we walk in, and it's Kanye, and it's Diddy, and you know a couple of people that we know, men. And it's immediately I was like, there's something not right. There's something not right about this, because we walk in and there's 9 other women there. And don't kill me for this, because this is what they call them. There were 9 studio hoes there. Strange, but okay.And we walk in and there's all these ladies there wearing their club gear, and Kanye and Diddy are already like out of their fucking mind, just like completely fucked up, drunk, but probably something else.
这是崔老爹惯用的招数之一，先让你看到很疯狂的场景，测试一下你能否接受。一旦你觉得 OK， 那他就会对你进行下一步。
Diddy hands me a drink, Kanye hands Warren a drink, and we're like, that's weird. Why are they serving us?And I don't like to drink.
像 Nicki 是非常不喜欢喝酒，于是他就拿着杯子假装喝一下，但他的经纪人就遭殃了。劳伦平时是一个很社恐的人，而当他喝下康也给的酒，马上脸红，而且变得非常社牛。
And my manager was sitting across from me. She's very much reserved, and people would always say like, oh, she's such a bitch. She has like a resting bitch face. And it's because she has like severe like social anxiety. Like she just wants to like sit in the corner and like tap on her phone and like not talk to anyone.2 sips and I watch her face flush, and all of a sudden like I look over and she's speaking really loud and like making jokes, and I'm like, whoa, like this isn't her, like she doesn't make jokes, she's fucking terrified of people, like she doesn't even talk. And I was like, it's already hitting her, like 100% I just knew that the drinks were all laced with something.
注意， Nicki 是这个工作室里唯一一个没有喝下来路不明的酒，所以当他看到工作室里的人突然变得很疯狂的时候，他立刻就意识到这个酒里有毒品，于是他马上拿起手机发短信警告经纪人不要喝，结果康也直接没收了他的手机。
My manager was like across the room, but like close enough, but like not next to me, so I couldn't like whisper to her, but I wanted to tell her, I'm like, hey, don't fucking drink this, there's something wrong with this, but I couldn't.So I reach for my phone and I start to type, and Kanye takes the phone out of my hand and he's like, who are you texting? Like, you don't need to text anyone, like we're having a party. And I was like, okay, and he like puts it on one of the speakers and I'm like, fuck.
崔纽迪和康也见到 Nicki 再次妥协之后，他俩觉得是时候对 Nicki 下手了。
And she walks out. I realize that I'm in the studio with Diddy and Kanye, and they're both off their shit, and there's 3 other men, an executive that works with Kanye, his engineer, and his cousin, and me.Alone. Kanye and Diddy have realized that I'm the only girl in the room, and they start coming towards me and they're like, don't you want to take your clothes off? Like, it's so hot in here. And I'm like, no, I'm fine like this. And they're like, come on, like, it's just us, like, we're all just friends, like, let us just like see like how you look. And I'm like, okay, I'm fine. And like, I still haven't gotten scared yet, you know, like, I'm still like, this is a bad situation, I'm creeped out, but like, there's no reason to panic, there's other men here. And I'm still not completely terrified yet, but I'm like, you guys stop, like stop, stop. And they're getting to the point where they have like ripped my shirt off. And like,I'm like almost fully exposed at this point.
而接下来发生的事情才是让 Nicki 真正感到无比恐惧。当他向旁边一位50岁并有家庭的男性以及刚结婚生完女儿的工程师发出求救信号时，他们竟然都选择了视而不见。
I'm like, you guys, like seriously, this isn't funny anymore. And I look to my left where his executive is. Like, we know him pretty well. Like, we've been around him a lot. He's literally 3 feet.Away from me, like if I reached, he reached too. Like we could touch, like he's that close. And I look, and I'm like, hey, like I give that look where I'm just like, come on, like step in, like this isn't cool. Like you're a grown man, like you're like 50 years old. I know you have a family, like you know this isn't right. Like do something. And this is the part that, for as long as I live, I will never fucking forget. It isn't actually the aspect of being sexually assaulted. That's not what haunts me. It's this. As these 2 grown men. were pawing at me, trying to take my clothes off. I look over to this man asking for help, and I literally mouth the word help, and we lock eyes, and he looks away. I'm like, okay, there's two more men in the room. And I look to his engineer next, who's sitting right next to him. And I know that he's married and he just had a little baby girl. And I'm like, okay, he's gonna do something. And I look at him next and I'm like, okay, like do something, say something, do anything. And he looks down at his phone and starts texting. And then I look at Kanye's cousin next. And I'm like, do something, you know, like fucking do something. And he spins his chair around.
Nikki 彻底意识到今晚没有人来救他了，他现在只能靠自己。眼睛一闭，快速冷静下来，他在想到底有什么办法能赶快离开这个鬼地方。背后是玻璃，而唯一的一个出口居然在这两个恶魔的后面。不管了，冲吧。
They were already drunk off their shit. They were fucked up. So I lunged forward. I stepped forward.And it like threw them off balance. Like they were like, oh, you know, and like they stepped back at least a foot and a half. And the moment that they did, I reached behind my back, I pulled the door and I slipped out, grabbing my clothes.
Nikki 这股勇气拯救了自己。而当他成功躲到没有人的录音室时，他突然缓过神来。他被刚刚的性侵、旁人的冷漠而产生强烈的绝望恐惧感，使他躲在角落哭了20多分钟。随后他抓准时机找到经纪人，马上打车回家。这次死里逃生让他对音乐产业彻底失去了信心，并以此为戒告诫大家。
Moral of the fucking story.Stay out of the industry. If you have daughters, make sure to tell them that they're idols they should never meet and to never fucking go to the studio with anyone, even if you're invited there as an artist, unless you have a bodyguard with you. Anyway, that's one of the main reasons that I almost lost my love for music and I got the fuck out of that place.
崔妮老爹和康业亲手毁掉了 Nikki 对音乐的热爱。细思极恐的是，这件事情发生之后， Nikki 的音乐生涯从巅峰直线下滑。不久后，他就宣布退出音乐产业，去到一个人迹罕至的农场里疗伤，过着自己真正想要的生活。上周，崔妮老爹正在尝试第四次交5000万的保释金出狱，而法官选择这周再做出决定。如果崔妮老爹现在还不能获得保释的话，那他很有可能要一直待在监狱里，直到明年5月才开始进行审判。点赞关注 ，Careful 会及时跟进崔妮老爹的最新进展以及更多不为人知的秘密。